remove. Let's see what the battery's at. Down to 2. Way to do this, watch. Well, that was a way to do it. That's one way of doing it too. Get the shit out of it. This is not a scientific test. This ain't torque test channel. Landscaper, that's what I do for a living. I'm kind of bored. It's like it's not snowing, you know, kind of no money to be made. You know, kind of no money to be made when it doesn't snow. Down to 1 bar. Unit's pretty fucking warm. Like I say, I couldn't remove that one leg. Couldn't even put it in because this is an impact driver. That's why I can't wait to get that Nuplex compact impact wrench in 3/8. I think it's good. I heard it spins just like an impact driver, so it has RPMs. I'm going to put it against all my compact impact wrenches and all my impact drivers, and I'm hoping it beats everything. I know it won't beat the 921 DeWalt. Okay, what's next? Let's see here. I'm bored. Bored. Okay, let us run these stubbies. Let's run these stubbies. Even though these are kind of big for an impact driver. Look at them. They vary from 2.5 to 3.5. A couple might go to 4 inches. Thank you. batteries at. Down to one bar and flashing. This is pretty hot now. Not many guys are willing to put their Kobalt to hell and back. Let's see how many more of these I can do. Let's just go with the big ones. Not even bother to waste our time with the small ones. I have spent probably $400 or $500 on fasteners in the past 2 years of doing this channel. Look at these mother humpers. This ain't gonna drive this. I can drive this, I bet, with a new Flex Compact Impact wrench, I bet. Okay. Meantime, let's let the battery try to come back. Let's see what it does. Down to one bar. Let's try to put let's put that one. Let's not do that one. Let's not do those two. Let's do just two more. Down to one and it's flashing. Yeah, this is pretty warm. But like I say, I'm gonna go online when I get done with this video. I'm sure somebody makes an adapter to put a Flex battery on here. That would be really interesting. Stacked lithium, 24 volt, 24 volt. I'm sure this would fly because they don't have stacked lithium for cobalt yet. Okay, let's remove these. See grease coming out already. I smell it too. It's starting to ooze out just a little bit. This is the best impact driver that Kobalt makes, without a doubt. Not that other one. That other one, oh my God. Okay. I'm not even going to bother to drive these little timber locks. They're a waste of space. So are these ledger locks. They're an absolute waste of space. Okay. Let's try this. We can drive at least one. We're down to one battery and it's flashing. You know, everything's pre-drilled here, you know. Let's try to find the easiest hole. Let's just put it. Limit on this. Battery's flashing. I'm smelling the grease. I like torture testing all my tools. Not many guys are willing to do that. I'm willing to torture test a tool that costs $500. I don't care. Man's got to have a hobby. One can't smoke, drink, and play with drugs and expect to live long. I'm 57, and I don't do any of the above. I've been married for 28 years, and I don't mess around. Better things to do. Like Jay Leno says, it's best to have 1,000 cars and one wife than one car and 1,000 girlfriends. Yeah. See if I can go any further with it. Forget it. Let's remove it. I won't even remove it. Well, I think this test is done. This thing is hot. I see just a little bit of grease. And the battery was fully charged. Battery's fully charged. And down to the last, and it's flashing. So let's consider this a full test of a Kobalt 24 volt max XTR impact driver, 2400 inch pounds, and it does 3400 RPMs, I think that is. I don't know how many impacts per minute it does. I'm sure it's probably close to four. And it can take a licking and keep on ticking. I'll have to count how many were put in, but I'm sure it was over 50. Eric the Bearded Tool Guy signing off.